Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Remember that Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. So where Jesus left, Christ, our Satguru, Nanak Devji, he took it over and then led it to completion with another prophet, Gobind Rai Ji. He was a royal king, the last prophet. So, Happy New Year. And today I was reading Bible I get on email, Bible reading, and I found a passage which was quite instructive, and I thought I render its exposition. It is Matthew 5, Luke 5, 27 to 29, and the other one. So, however, here it is. And after Jesus, and after these things, he went forth and saw a publican named Levi sitting at the receipt of custom, tax collector, you know, he was. And he said unto him, "Join me." In the Bible it's written, "Follow me." He doesn't say, follow me. Follow, only the blind people follow. The people who are not blind, they join you. That means we have a fellowship of the seekers. We do not have somebody to follow us. So in the Church of God, where there are twice born people, none of them follow anyone, not even Christ, Jesus. But they understand the word of God and then they walk towards the royal kingdom of our Father God, seeking the narrow gate and entering into his royal kingdom. And he left all, that means material thing, rose up and joined him. And Levi made him a great feast in his own house. So he invited him into his own house. He must be having a big house. Well, being a tax collector, getting quite a good job, you know, collecting taxes and then sending it to the Romans. And there was a great company of publicans and of others that sat down with them. Now, the gospel is received by those who are mentally alert, or who have common sense. Though these publicans and other people who deal with the general public, they are not stupid people. They are met many men and they are men of integrity, and also they can tell you, you know, this man is a good or a bad one. So they knew, these publicans, that these temple rabbis and temple priests, they are hypocrites. They say something different, do something different. So the company in which Jesus sat was of people who were twice born, and they were not drunk with the old wine of the letters as the rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees were. But their scribes and Pharisees murmured. Scribes and Pharisees, they are both men of letters, dry of common sense. You will find people who are men of letters, they do not exercise common sense. They just go by what is written in the book. So these scribes and Pharisees, they took them for sinners because they were transgressing against the moral laws. So they murmured against his laborers. Now Jesus had laborers and not disciples. Laborers, he employed them in the vineyard of God. And at Pentecost, they were paid their wage. So these messianic Jews, they twisted the Bible and put the word disciple in Jesus. In Jesus, we do not have disciples. Disciples, they are once born and they do what they are told to do. They follow the instruction of their moral teacher, which is named a rabbi. But Jesus was not a moral teacher. He was a preacher of his word, gospel preacher. So gospel is only understood by people who are twice born, sensible. So sensible people, they are not asked to follow you blindly, but they are asked to grasp, understand it. So that's what Jesus did, you know, with his laborers. He employed them in the vineyard of our Father and trained them in the workmanship or how to look after the vineyard. Vineyard is this secular word. So why do ye eat, Pharisee and Sadducee says, why do ye eat and drink with publicans and sinners? To them, you know, anybody who transgresses against the moral law is a sinner. That means they must say prayers, kosher, this and that, you know. Anybody who did not do any of their rituals, he was called a sinner. And Jesus said unto them, they that are whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. So Jesus answered to them that those who are whole mean physically or spiritually fit, no sickness, they don't need a physician. But people who are sick, you know, they need a doctor. And that's why Christ Jesus came among the Jews, because they were sick. The Gentile, they were whole, they were physically whole, spiritually whole. They did not need a doctor. That's why Christ, Philip, one of the laborers who became apostle, said that a Gentile never dies, for he does not live to die. So Samaritan woman at the well gave a good demonstration of the spiritually healthy and whole people. When all of them were gathered there, then Jesus said, look at the crop, it is white. White means white-hearted. Crop doesn't mean the crop you see in the field. Crop is the people. That is our crop. We have to fish them. They were all white-hearted. Even the Samaritan woman, when she went to the village back after giving a sound discussion to Jesus, she did not say, go and believe what I say. She said, go, I have found the man. Go and test him in spirit yourself. Speak to him to yourself and get satisfaction yourself. Do not believe in me. So that is what it is, that in Jesus we do not impose views. So people are asked to ask question to us, and any doubts we try to clear them up, but it's up to the God our Father to give you the gospel. We can't give you. And they said unto him, why do the disciple of John the Baptist fast often and make prayers? Remember that John the Baptist was a Levite priest of Moses. So the priests, they deal with Adam and the once born children. So it's they who need the prayer and fasting. Fasting keep you healthy. Your physical body need rest. So fasting is the way to give rest to your system. So they pray. Twice born people do not pray. That was Christ Thomas said, why should I fast? What sin have I committed? Why should I pray? What wrong have I done? So twice born people do not pray or fast. Unless they have done something wrong, then they go and pray within themselves. They don't make a noise as in church you see them. After a little while, the priest will say, oh, let's pray. Bend, put your head down, let's pray. Those priests, they are working for mammon, not for God. By putting on that dog collar, they pretend to the people that they are men of God. They are not. They are hypocrites that Jesus predicted. However, let's go to the... So in Jesus, we do not pray or fast. We ponder over his word. So the John the Baptist, he was a Levi moral teacher, ideal moral teacher. So his disciple, they read scriptures and they pondered, they fasted and prayed. While in Christ Jesus, he was twice born, they knew our Father knows the matters of their heart. So there is no need to blah, blah, blah in churches. And they ponder over his word and do his will. His will is gospel, which is meat. That Christ Jesus came to feed us. That's why Jesus, when he broke the bread, he said, this is my body, meat, eat it. So the prayer then that these people say in churches, give us our bread, you know, is not the bread made of wheat. The bread is his word. If you are twice born, then it is a meat for you, because when you chew it or when you understand it, then you know the meaning and the hidden meaning in the parables. But thine eat and drink, he said that to Christ Jesus, that your laborers, they eat and drink, they don't give time to prayers or other thing. In Jesus, you know, we do not pray. We enjoy our life because the heavy yoke of the sin have been removed from our shoulder. So when it has been removed, then we enjoy. We receive gospel. Gospel means good news of our Father. And in his good news, we eat and drink and enjoy. Not more like those Pharisees and Sadducees who used to put on heavy yokes. God bless you.